Welcome to the 2020 ACT Culmination, our first ever online culmination event. Here's Phyllis Gadowski.
It's going to be an enjoyable ride to see what you've accomplished this whole year. And you could see here the coordinators, David Kretschmer in elementary, Brian Foley, secondary, Nancy Burstein, special education, Zen Chai, early childhood special education, and myself, what we call me, is a K-12 district liaison. If you want to know about a district, I'm the person to ask. And of course, we could never, ever accomplish this without our director, Nancy Burstein. She has directed this program since she, David, and I started, well, should I say it, Nancy and David, back in the 90s, creating this program a long time. And we haven't aged a bit. Just take a look at us. So here we are. We have one more person to thank on this list, and that's Chris McDonald. She is our administrative assistant. She kind of puts everything together. She's actually the first person that you may encounter on this journey. So thank you to Chris, thank you to the coordinators, and of course, Dr. Burstein, for your leadership for all these years. And shall I say it? Almost 25 years. Wow, we're still here. I don't know, before you know it, we're going to be in our wheelchairs, walking out, and well, not even walking out, in our wheelchairs saying, here we come, the ACT coordinators. Well, thank you all for coming. We have well over 100 and almost 160 folks online. We are ready. We're not going to let this pandemic stop us, but we want to remind you, to always be careful. Wear that mask. That is why this vision is on the screen right now. And so as we move forward, we want to thank all of you for coming. We want to thank the families, the husbands, the wives, the mothers, the fathers, the children, the loved ones, the friends, for supporting you throughout this whole journey. It hasn't been easy. It hasn't been easy because some of them have been up 24/7 working hard to make sure they've become the best teacher they can be. So while we get started, our first person is somebody who has been a tremendous supporter of the ACT program. We can go to her with any questions. She is always there to support us. She is Dr. Sherry Tarver-Baring, the Dean of the Michael Eisner College of Education. So take it away, Dr. Sherry.
Thank you. Thank you, Nancy. Welcome, everyone. Welcome, elementary, secondary, and special education ACT credential completers. Welcome, family and friends. And welcome all of the faculty and mentor teachers and supporting people who have made it possible for these students to get to this point today. The ACT program is the diamond in the crown of the College of Education, recognized across the greater Los Angeles school districts as producing some of the best teachers ever. And I am proud to have been a part of this ACT program and also been here for 25 years, first as a faculty and now as an administrator, to watch the incredible teachers that come from this program. Now, this year, not only is it the most challenging program normally, but you had the challenge of the pandemic, which Phyllis has just described to you. And so you have had even more challenges than normal, and you are absolute heroes for getting to the finish line here. I'm going to call on you now to do something in your future. As you know, this weekend around the world, great strife is erupting over injustice. And one of the places that we can teach social justice, equity, access, and inclusion, along with the very fundamental educational standards that we promote, is in schools. I'm going to call on you, the graduating class of ACT, to make a difference in this world. It is on you as teachers to teach kindness and social justice as you move forward with your other curriculum that you are so excellent at promoting. So today, go forward, make us proud, show the world that we can be a better place. And thank you again for being a part of this excellent program. Congratulations, and best of luck to you in everything you do in your future.
Good morning. My name is David Kretschmer. I'm the coordinator for the elementary cohort within the ACT program. One of the great things about being a coordinator in a program such as ACT is that you are afforded the opportunity to shepherd a group of students from beginning to end in their quest to become teachers. While the 1920 cohort of future elementary teachers is small, it's mighty. This is a cohort of future teachers that has demonstrated the critical qualities that we would wish for all teachers, for all children. So who are the cast of characters of the 22nd elementary cohort? Many have been out in the world pursuing other dreams before they came to understand that their real dream is to become a teacher. Still, others knew early on that they wanted to become teachers, that they wanted to devote their lives to children. Teaching profession welcomes anyone, but it takes a person of particular qualities to make it to be a teacher. Future elementary teachers that we are here to honor today have demonstrated those qualities. Through a tumultuous year, members of this cohort have demonstrated caring and respect for one another, a consistent focus on developing their abilities as teachers, a drive to the end of 10 challenging months. They have demonstrated flexibility, a quality so important to a teacher, for one can never know what a new day will bring. One of the positive outcomes of COVID-19 and school closures, if there is a silver lining, is that society has come to realize the value of teachers to our local communities and school and society as a whole. Teachers, and particularly elementary teachers, have to possess an amalgam of special knowledge and skills that are unique to the profession. What does one have to know to teach a child how to read and write, develop mathematical thinking, inquire into and interpret their role through science, understand the significance of historical events and societal structures, and construct and deconstruct works of art? Teachers also teach character in children how to care, to appreciate and respect differences, to get along with others, to persevere in the face of adversity, and to be curious yet skeptical, to be good citizens in a time when much of the message out there is counter to that principle. Teachers are truly special people to whom society entrusts its youngest humans in a quest to prepare the next generation of caring, responsible citizens. This group of future elementary teachers has lived up to those ideals, and to all of you, I thank you for your passion and dedication to your craft. With that, I would like to introduce Jennifer Schwartz, who is this year's cohort of elementary teachers has selected to represent them at this event.
Okay, well first, thank you, Dr. Kretschmer. First, I would like to extend a huge congratulations to the ACT 22 cohort and a gigantic thank you to our loved ones, professors, mentor teachers, and supervisors who supported us and cheered for us during this journey. These past 10 months have been quite a ride with twists and turns that we never expected, but we all got through it together. And in many ways, this experience is one that we'll never forget. I'd like to start by sharing something I read the other day that absolutely blew my mind. It sent me down a path of thinking about all of us, this program, and what we might face as we begin our teaching careers. What I read was about Quidditch. Now, for those of you who might not be well-versed in the language of Harry Potter, Quidditch is the main sport played in the Wizarding World. It's sort of an amalgamation of rugby, dodgeball, and polo, but the players fly around on broomsticks. And it can get pretty rough at times. On Twitter, J.K. Rowling, the author and creator of the Harry Potter series, responded to a fan who questioned her about the Quidditch scoring system, saying that it made no sense. You see, the game of Quidditch can easily be won by catching the golden snitch, which is a golden ball, a tiny ball about the size of a ping pong ball that flies around the court during the game. But even if a player catches the golden snitch, their team can still lose if the opposing team has accrued more points. So, in response to the fan's comment, J.K. Rowling said this: "It makes perfect sense. There's glamour in chasing an elusive lucky break, but teamwork and persistence can still win the day. Everyone's vulnerable to blows of fate and obstructive people, and success means rising above them. Quidditch is the human condition. Well, after reading that, my jaw was on the floor. I mean, I always thought that Quidditch was just Quidditch. Who knew that it was a metaphor for life? Like the Quidditch players, we had a gigantic obstacle, or as she says, a blow of fate to contend with this semester. A global pandemic that closed our schools, our campus, and impacted all of our lives. But like the best of teams, we pulled together. This was not a time to go it alone. Even though there was so much solitude and we were all physically separated from each other, we stayed connected through email, text, Facebook, and even took advantage of times during our Zoom classes to vent and lean on each other. When I reached out to my classmates for input about their experience in the ACT program, there were definitely some common threads. The benefits of being a member of this incredible cohort and the friendships that we made. We all brought our unique strengths, life experiences, and curiosities into this program. As a cohort, we learned from each other, supported each other, and gave that support freely and willingly. If someone asked for help or advice, there was never a moment of hesitation. The help was there. Knowing that we were going through this together and that we were all experiencing similar anxieties, challenges, and successes made all the difference. Those feelings of togetherness became even more important once we could no longer physically be together. As our classmate Jessica said, logging into Zoom and seeing all 20 of us there gave her the motivation to keep pressing forward. Looking at everyone's slides, which all of you will see in just a moment, there are so many remarks about friendship, the joy of making new friends, and how we couldn't have gotten through this without each other. This program even brought old friends back together again. Helen and Vanna were great friends growing up, but hadn't seen each other since Helen transferred to a new school in 10th grade. They had no idea that they had both joined the ACT program, but they quickly picked up right where they had left off. As Helen said, as time goes on, friendships can still be strong. I have a feeling that as time goes on, our friendships will stay strong as well. Beginning any career can be very scary. For some of us, this is a second or even third career. Still, we are beginning our teaching careers in a time of great uncertainty. We can only speculate what our classrooms, actual or virtual, might look like in the fall. However, I can say with certainty that we will do all we can to create supportive and vibrant learning environments for our students and enrich their education with everything that we learned here at CSUN. Through all the twists and turns, I think we would have all lost our collective minds had it not been for the calm and steady support of Dr. Kretschmer. Dr. K, you've been there for all of us since day one. You always had time to talk, email, and even allowed us to hijack the beginnings of your Zoom classes to pepper you with questions. But like always, you got us back on track. And thank you to every single professor, mentor teacher, and university supervisor who turned themselves inside out to ensure that we could complete this program under these extraordinary circumstances. Thank you from all of us from the bottom of our hearts. And so Act 22, we did it. And we have volumes and volumes of lesson plans to prove it. We have an awesome responsibility ahead of us. We're tasked with helping the young humans in our charge make some sense of this world and hopefully laugh and make some great friends along the way. I know that we did. Wherever we end up, I hope that we will all be part of a team that helps us navigate those unexpected blows of fate. There's no need to go it alone. After these past 10 months, I think we can all agree that J.K. Rowling was right. Teamwork and persistence can definitely win the day. Thank you. And now I would like to introduce my peers from the elementary cohort. Thank you.
Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
And all that glitters is gold.
Only shooting stars break the mold. It's a cool place, and they say it gets colder. You're bundled up now, wait till you get older. But the media men beg to differ, judging by the hole in the satellite picture. The ice we skate is getting pretty thin. The water's getting warm, so you might as well swim. My world's on fire, how about yours? That's the way I like it, and I'll never get bored. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid. Only shooting stars break the mold. Somebody once asked, could I spare some change for gas? I need to get myself away from this place. I said, yeah, what a concept. I could use a little fuel myself, and we could all use a little change. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Back to the rules and I'll hit the ground running. It makes sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
And all that glitters is gold.
Only shooting stars break the mold.
Good morning. How are we doing out there? This is our first ever online culmination. I hope everybody was able to hear us and see everything okay. My name is Brian Foley. I'm the coordinator for the Secondary Education Act Group, the middle school and high school teachers. And I'm the newbie here. So this is my first year coordinating the ACT program. Carolyn Birch had been in charge of the secondary group for 20 years. And she told me, you know, the program pretty much runs itself. It's the same every year. Nothing ever happens. Thanks, Carolyn. It's been an eventful year. It's been kind of crazy. So much that negativity, things that have happened, you know, we know people are still having to go to school and going to work and being heroic. There's a lot of sort of darkness, but there's also some really positive things. I was encouraged to see the student teachers jump into online teaching with 2 feet. I watched online classes where student teachers were using all kinds of great tools and techniques. Some of them they learned in my class, which I was happy to see. And sometimes the mentor teacher wasn't even around. So this group of student teachers is very resilient. They're able to solve problems and they're focused on student learning. So I'm very enthusiastic about how this group will do. I know our students are going to be in great hands with them in the future, hopefully in person, but at least if it's online, they know how to do that too. So I want to thank all the secondary group and for helping me have an exciting, it was always going to be a memorable first year, but they helped me get through it. And so it's been great. And a really wonderful bunch of people. So I'm going to now invite Jeffrey Root to speak on behalf of the secondary education cohort.
Thank you, Brian. All right, hopefully everybody can hear me out there. This is my first time giving a speech and I'm not sure why I volunteered for this, but here it goes. That was an easy school year. Everything went according to plan. We all feel 110% ready for our first year of teaching without any concerns of what the future of our profession looks like. Many of us are accepting jobs where we know there will be no surprises, just good old-fashioned teaching. All of our students are going to be perfect little angels, and we'll all be millionaires within a few years, living in our mansions. Ah, the teacher life. But let's get real here. As someone with ADD and dyslexia, which I am reading off of a speech, so if I make any mistakes, I have an excuse, I avoided any online classes in my undergrad. I just knew I would fail without the student-teacher interaction that I needed to stay focused. I made a decision to search for a teaching program 3 years ago with a kick in the pants from my life partner, Ellie, but I was on the road, so I put it on hold until I landed permanently in a city where I could attend a school in person. CSUN was the perfect fit for me then and continued to be so throughout this pandemic. I know I was not alone in my struggles with online learning and teaching this semester. For those of you tuning in to watch your loved ones graduate, you may already know the stress they were under throughout the year. Everyone in this program, from the student teachers, mentors, instructors, and administrators, all had to adapt and continue to be flexible through the credentialing process and the uncertainty of what the coming months and even years look like. It is a time of variable term waivers for many who did not have the opportunity to record their sample lessons before the sudden change. Many will have the opportunity in the fall to complete the teacher performance assessment, but it makes you no less of a teacher. You have been a teacher for the last 9 months. You know the hard work you put in, so do not let anyone tell you any different. Like many before becoming a teacher, I had dreams of dressing in a leather jacket like Michelle Pfeiffer in the movie Dangerous Minds and cleverly teaching anaphora using song lyrics. The students appreciated the lyrics of Kendrick Lamar, but still thought I was a nerd. I forgot to wear the leather jacket. I thought about standing on my desk like Robin Williams in Dead Poets Society and reciting "O Captain, My Captain" in order to inspire my students to love Walt Whitman. I found it doesn't take an expensive private institution to encounter the most inspiring minds. Also, I was trying to keep my student teaching position and did not want to crack my head open in front of a bunch of 11th graders. Perhaps someday I will be more confident. These movies show you a class size of about 15 students, and for some reason, the other four periods are non-existent. You will never see a more intimidating sight than when you walk into a class of 39 eighth graders with out-of-control hormones. 50 minutes later, you will do it again, and in another 50, again, and two more times after that, for 180 days. The school usually has an assigned textbook, but how often do we really use that to create 180 days of instruction? More often than not, we create lessons from scratch and we swap lessons with each other. Every teacher knows the pain of another, and I have met some of the most giving student teachers in this program, including the mentor teachers and our instructors. We could not have done it without them. At the beginning of the school year, this fall, we will have no idea who is going to walk through that door or pop up into our Zoom sessions. In all the chaos with all of the disruptions, it can often be difficult to remember that our students come from different homes, and in some cases, no home at all. They speak different languages. Some students may be top performers, but will suffer from parents who push them to the point of anxiety. Others will have no one involved in their education and will have teachers who have given up on them early in their schooling. There will be those who get lost in the background noise. As teachers, we must always remember that it is never too late for any of our students. Some of you knew I would find a way to sneak my hero Carl Sagan, renowned astrophysicist, into the speech. I'm an English teacher, but I think the following quote can be applied to every single subject taught. When it comes to the importance of listening to children, Sagan writes, "I find many adults are put off when young children pose scientific questions. Why is the moon round? The children ask. Why is the grass green? What is a dream? How deep can you dig a hole? When is the world's birthday? Why do we have toes?" Too many teachers and parents answer with irritation or ridicule, or quickly move on to something else. What did you expect, the moon to be square? Children soon recognize that somehow this kind of question annoys grown-ups. A few more experiences like it, and another child has been lost to science. Why adults should pretend omniscience to omniscience before six-year-olds, I can't for the life of me understand. What's wrong with admitting that we don't know something? Is our self-esteem so fragile? Sagan's words are a reminder that we must continue to be humble as teachers, even 20 or 30 years down the road. We have to bring ourselves back to that moment when we were first learning about the world. Don't ever tell a student their life is easy. They are only beginning to understand who they are as individuals. They know all eyes are on them, and they are very self-aware of their appearance and how they act around others. They are their greatest judges, and we should be there to provide them with opportunities to explore their potential as human beings. I would like to close by quoting Abraham Lincoln from the historically accurate event where he helped save two students, Bill S. Preston Esquire and Ted Theodore Logan, from flunking their history report at San Dimas High School back in 1989. When addressing the student population, Lincoln stated, "Be excellent to each other," and "Party on, dudes!"
'Cause you're a sky, 'cause you're a sky full of stars. I'm gonna give you my heart. 'Cause you're a sky, 'cause you're a sky full of stars. 'Cause you light up the path. I'm
Hello, everyone. It's my pleasure to talk a little bit about the special ed cohort. My name is Nancy Burstein. I coordinate this group, and you can see on the slide all of their names are listed there, both in mild moderate disabilities and early childhood special education. Well, and what a different world. You've heard everyone talk about this when I met all of you only a year ago. I interviewed each of you and asked you why you wanted to become a special ed teacher. You talked about your patients, how you were drawn to students with special needs, how you really felt you could make a difference to help students succeed and thrive. Such potential, I thought, individually and as a cohort. You had so much to offer. And throughout the year, you displayed these qualities and so much more. However, little did you know what was in store for you in the coming spring. But you adapted to your new and ever-changing circumstances with grace and resilience. In many ways, you are pioneers, learning with your mentors a new way of teaching. I have no doubt that this coming year you will forge new ground and be prepared for whatever challenges you face. You are ready. And indeed, you will make a difference. Our children need you perhaps more than ever before. And while you have learned so much this year from faculty, your mentor teachers, and from each other, there is so much more to learn. Don't hesitate to reach out to your colleagues for support and guidance, those you have met in the ACT program and colleagues you will work with next year. Finally, I want to acknowledge Phyllis Gadowski, your teacher and supervisor who tirelessly supported you throughout every phase of this program. And I was so inspired by your quotes that I want to leave you with this quote from Mary Hatwood Futrell, a very influential educator. And I quote, "When the untapped potential of a student meets the liberating art of a teacher, a miracle unfolds." I look forward to hearing about your many miracles. Congratulations to all of you and to our special ed cohort. And now I have the honor of introducing Scott Maxwell, who's representing the special ed at cohort.
Thank you, Dr. Burstein. As we look back on this past year and our time in this program, a few words come to mind: uncertainty, enlightenment, passion, compassion, and perseverance. First, passion. For some of us, this career in the field of teaching have been our passion forever. For some of us, we discovered it later in life. Many of us have experienced working in other career fields, but knew something was missing, that our work was not fulfilling as we wanted it to be. Those of us who took this step and that leap and chose to enter this program, I commend you for your bravery of stepping out into the unknown and choosing to follow your passion. Uncertainty. This word carries with it even more weight nowadays because of the current situation the world finds itself in. But many of us know what uncertainty feels like. It's that feeling we had on the first day of class when we all got to meet each other. It's that feeling when we first found out the schools we'd be teaching at. It's that feeling you had when you stepped onto campus and into your classroom for the first time and got to meet the students you'd be working with for the next several months. It's the feeling you may have had throughout the semester, and even now while looking for the next school you're going to call home and pour your heart into. But through it all, long nights, early mornings, the countless quizzes, tests, and dreaded RECA and CSET exams, we decided to keep pushing forward through the uncertainty. Enlightenment. During our time in the ACT program, we were able to be taught by some tremendous educators. They gave us valuable insight through their own personal experience on how to meet the needs of our diverse population of students. The time in their classrooms was a phenomenal time to be able to relearn and update our thoughts on instruction and what was possible in order to reach our students. even though there were long nights, weekends spent, those aha moments where it clicked and the information stuck made them worth it. So we want to say thank you to all the wonderful instructors we were so lucky to have during our time in the ACT program. Because of your passion and willingness to pour into us, we feel prepared to attack the challenges ahead of us in our careers. Compassion. In the first meeting we all attended in Manzanita Hall on that hot September day, I don't think we would all find so many people who we'd be able to call friends by the end of the year. But this program has shown that some people just come along at the right time in your life, right when you need them the most. We cheer for each other no matter the accomplishment, and we reach out and check on one another just to let that person know that you're there for them. The camaraderie, love, and compassion that Cohort 22 possesses amazes me. And finally, perseverance. This year has been filled with many hardships, for many of us personal, but some hardships we all shared in. Whether it's fires, staying Saga strong, or COVID-19, we as a collective whole have done our best to persevere for our students and for each other. Because at the end of the day, our passion to continue to shape young people's lives in a positive manner cannot be destroyed. These instances reminded us of a valuable lesson. It's not the situation you find yourself in that defines you, but how you respond to it. In closing, there are many people that made this past year and our time in this program possible. I want to say thank you to everyone listening, especially those of who are not with us anymore, but watching from up above. All of you who support us through this journey, mothers, fathers, siblings, extended family, friends, and faculty. Thank you to all of you who poured into us encouragement and support throughout this time. I wanted to especially thank Phyllis Godowski and Dr. Nancy Burstein for their unwavering support during this year. You two went above and beyond the call of duty to make sure that we were successful, and you two are a big reason why this program is so special. I can say that we as a cohort are excited to move forward, but sad to say goodbye. I know that we're proud to call each other colleagues and look forward to many years of friendship and growth together. Now I'd like to present the ACT Special Education Cohort of 2020.
Can't read my mind, I'm undefined. I'm just beginning, the pen's in my hand, ending unplanned. Staring at the blank page before you, open up the dirty window, let the sun illuminate the words that you could not find. Reaching for something in the distance, so close you can almost taste it. Release your inhibitions, feel the rain on your skin. No one else can feel it for you, only you can let it in. No one else, no one else can speak the words on your lips. Treat yourself in words unspoken, live your life with arms wide open. Today is where your book begins, the rest is still unwritten. Sometimes my tries are outside the line. We've been conditioned to not make mistakes, but I can't live that way. Staring at the blank page before you, open up the dirty window, let the sun illuminate the words that you could not find. Reaching for almost taste it, release your inhibitions, feel the rain on your skin. No one else can feel it for you, only you can let it in. No one else, no one else can speak the words on your lips. Put yourself in words unspoken, live your life with arms wide open. Today is where your book begins, the rest is still unwritten.
Yes, the rest is still written. From the words of that song, and from all of what we heard from our speakers, to Jennifer, to Jeffrey and Scott, they exemplify what this program is all about. Probably everyone in this cohort could have given a speech That's how great they are. Our students are so lucky to have these future teachers be their teacher for life. I want to thank everyone who has come here today. We appreciate your attendance. This is very unusual for us. We did not expect to be doing this, but here we are, unusual times, as everyone has said, and just we are here to support all of you. And let's take a look at all of the folks that it took to create this program, and it is definitely a village. The elementary faculty and mentors, secondary faculty and mentors, university supervisors, and the Special Education Act faculty and mentors. You can see it took a lot of us to really get this program up and running, but the most important part, in my estimation, of this program are you, the future teachers. You are our future. You are the ones who will help us in the future become a great country once again, and also promote such wonderful future educators, scientists, doctors, lawyers, all the folks that are you are going to create for future. Those students are going to be very lucky to have you as your teacher. So we're closing this door, but we're not saying goodbye. We cannot say goodbye to you because we know we will see you again, whether it's at the university or in a school. And don't forget to say hi once you see us again. And we'd like to close with this saying that I think really exemplifies the education. I dreamed I stood in a studio and watched two sculptors there. The clay they used was a young child's mind, and they fashioned it with care. One was a teacher. The tools the teacher used were books and music and art. One was a parent with a guiding hand and a gentle, loving heart. And when at last their work was done, they were proud of what they had wrought, for the things they had worked into the child could never be sold or bought. And each agreed the teacher would have failed if the teacher had worked alone, for behind the parent stood the school, and behind the teacher stood the home. Nothing says it better than that. We wish you all the best of luck. Remember, wear your face mask, use your gloves, and wash your hands. Congratulations to all of you until we meet again.
Congratulations, everybody.